I held you down for the longest, and I was there through all of your darkest moments. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I wanted to do sort of like a rainbow sort of eye look. I wanted to give you guys some extra glam and just, you know, do it up a little bit. I had been seeing a lot of rainbow looks, and I really was like, hey, like, I want to try that. So this is what I came up with, and I hope that you guys enjoy. So if you want to see how I got this cute extra rainbow look, then go ahead and watch this video. So I already went and did my eyebrows off camera. If you guys want to know how I do my eyebrows, I will have my eyebrow tutorial linked down in the description box below, so go ahead and check that out if you want to see how I do my eyebrows. But I'm gonna jump right in on this look. So I'm going to be using the BH Cosmetics Take Me to Brazil palette to achieve the rainbow cut crease that I'm doing today. And the first brush I'm going to be using is my e.l.f. eyeliner brush. And this is like a flat brush. And I'm going to just use this to start off my cut crease. The first shade that I'm going to go in is this yellow shade right here in the middle of the palette. So let's go ahead, and I'm going to make my crease higher because I have kind of hooded eyelids. So I'm gonna kind of bring it up a little higher. I can see this yellow already. For our next shade, I'm going to go in with this orange right here, and I'm going to use that same brush, and I'm just going to take it in the middle of this yellow, and this is just going to start adding some color to the look. I'm going to kind of pack it up there at first, and then I'm going to kind of drag it a little outward and in to just make sure that it's nice and blended. And then I'm also gonna go back in with some more yellow just to make sure that we aren't drowning it out or anything. So after you finish adding the orange to the middle and I touched up the inside a little bit with a little bit more yellow, I'm going to now go in with this red shade right here. I'm still gonna use that same e.l.f. brush. I'm going to apply this to the outer wing of the cut crease. So it's going to kind of make like a swooping shade. And I'm going to use the red to kind of just follow the yellow and follow what the yellow was doing when I made that swoop. Now I'm going to go in with my Real Techniques Essential Crease Brush, and I'm going to dip back into those three shades. So I'm going to dip into the yellow, and then I'm going to bring it up here and kind of shade it a little bit. I want it to start to come up a little bit more onto the top of my crease. So this is going to make kind of like a shadow effect. So where I had it just in those areas, this is going to kind of space it out a little bit more on the top before we get ready to cut our crease. So after you've added the red shade on the end and you've kind of shaded out the other two colors, now I'm going to go ahead and cut my crease. Today I'm going to be using my NYX eyeshadow base, and this is in the shade white. Okay, now that our crease is cut, I'm gonna go ahead and start working on the lower lash line. So I'm going to take this Wet n Wild large eyeshadow brush and dip back into the BH Cosmetics palette. I'm going to go into this plum purple shade right here. Now to go ahead and set the lid shade, I'm going to be using the Wet n Wild eyeshadow in the shade Sugar.
not with that same eyeshadow brush that I used to put the purple underneath my eye. I'm going to go in with this blue shade right here. So I'm going to take this blue and I'm going to kind of smoke it underneath the bottom to just add another color to the bottom of the look. And then I'm going to smoke it out a little bit with this clean e.l.f. blending brush. Now for some fun, I'm going to go in with my NYX Vivid Brights eyeliner. And this is in the shade Vivid Sapphire. And I'm going to use this to make a wing liner. And this is going to be basically like a blue wing liner effect going on. So let's see how this works. Okay, and I'm actually gonna switch it up on the other side. So instead of using this shade, I'm going to go in with a different shade. If I can find it. It's the same brand, but this is in the shade Vivid Fire. Alright, so now that I have finished the other eyeliner, I'm going to go ahead and add some mascara and lashes off camera. So I'll be right back. Alright, now that I went ahead and applied my lashes and my mascara, I'm going to go ahead and start on the face. I wanted this video to mostly be about the eyes, so I'm going to go ahead and do my face on camera, but I'm not going to be talking or anything while I'm doing it. So I'm just going to go ahead and do my full face, and I'm going to have all of the products listed on the screen as I use them, so you guys will be able to see which products I use. And for any brushes and anything that I use, I'm going to have those in the description box down below in order, in case you guys want to know which brushes I used while I was doing my makeup. So after I finish baking, now I'm going to go ahead and add my highlight, and I'm going to be using the ColourPop Most Unnecessary Super Shock Cheek Highlighter today. I'm going to be using my Luxie 522 Tapered Highlighting Brush. Ooh, girl. That's bomb, okay? That's some bomb highlight, girl, okay? And then I'm going to go in with my Real Techniques fine liner brush and then go into the highlight. And I'm going to use this and put it on my brow bone. And then I'm also going to put a little bit more right here on my Cupid's bow. Because I've been doing this lately and I really think that it's super cute. As long as you're not too OD with it, I feel like it's very cute and it comes off really cute in pictures as well. And then for a little extra glow, I'm going to jump into my Carly Bible palette by BH Cosmetics. And I'm going to use the white highlighter out of this palette. And I'm not going to apply any Mario Badescu Rose Water Spray or anything like that because these highlighters are very pigmented and they give off a lot of product. So I'm just going to put a little bit on that fine liner brush and just put it on the tip of my nose. Like so. And as you see, like, it gives that little dot. And it's super cute. And then I'm going to add a little bit of that on my Cupid's bow. And you see a little goes a very long way with this highlighter. And then I'm going to spray it. And then I'm going to add it into my inner corner on my eye. I'm spraying it for this because I want it to be really extra in the inner corner. I'm gonna go ahead and set in my face using my Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water, and this is the 3-in-1, so it's a set and refresh spray. So you can use this as a primer, you can use this as a setting spray, and you can use this to refresh your face throughout the day when you have your makeup on if you need to do so. Now I'm going to go ahead and do my lip shade. I'm not 100% sure what I want my lips to be. I don't know if I want to go dark. I feel like if I go too dark, it's going to kind of take away from the eyes. And the eyes are kind of like the masterpiece of this whole thing, you know? For my lips, I'm going to be going in with this lip trio that I always use. This is literally my go-to lip trio that I do all the time. If I don't know what lip shade I want to use or anything like that, this is definitely my go-to. So I'm going to be using the NYX lip liner in the shade dark brown to line my lips. Okay, once I'm done with my liner, I'm going to go in with my NYX butter gloss, and this is in the shade Madeline. And for the last part of the trio, I'm going to be going in with my Victoria's Secret Lip Silk Sheer Gloss. And this doesn't have a shade name. It's just the light pink one. And voila, this is the end result. And from the looks of it, I am really enjoying this look. This is the first time I've ever done this hairstyle, so I'm kind of trying to get used to this hairstyle as well as this really dramatic look going on. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this little rainbow eyeshadow tutorial video. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on this video. And if you enjoyed this video, please comment down below. Go tell your friends, share this video. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So I hope to see you guys back with another video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye guys.